Hello viewers, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Varalakshmi. Formerly I worked in teaching and research in political philosophy at Department of Philosophy, Andhra University, Visakhapatnam. Today I am dealing with the module titled as The Rights of the Girl Child. This comes under the paper Child Rights. Now let us deal with the learning outcomes. This module deals with the rights of the girl child from a historical standpoint to the present day conception of rights and practice. And secondly, this module aims that by the end of the doing this with this module, one understands not only the plight of the girl child, but also looks into the significant need and special ways to protect the girl child. Now we shall deal with the introduction. Perceptions are very powerful messages for the progress or regress of the people, and perceptions can never be formed in isolation. They are the results of what we see and interact with them to take the better choices for existence, sustenance on earth. Today's development of women is the result of yesterday's perception of girl child by some progressive thinking people, and a child is brought up in such a progressive world. Persons are the products of perceptions. History and present day statistics reveal that there were and there are successful women. There were number of women who got Nobel Peace Prizes in various fields like chemistry, physics and peace. Jodie Williams, Betty Williams and Mother Teresa received Nobel Peace Prizes in the past history. In India, still, which is a developing country, despite its social and economic backwardness and discriminating attitudes towards women, many women were successful and helpful to children to transcend their dreams to reality. To name some are Kiran Bedi, who was the first woman IPS officer, Priya Jingam, who was the first woman to join in Indian Army, and Harita Kaul, who was the first woman to join in Indian Air Force, and Kalpana Chawla, who was the first woman to go into the space. India Today is the source of this information. Their successes were not only in their strong will and efforts, but also encouragement from the members of the family and the state at each stage of their life. But what is missing for the women to achieve success is, we find, such a welcoming attitude for girl child in the family and a healthy social and economic background. Thus, we still see today social evils like sexual exploitation of girls, children as domestic servants, children in trafficking and other sorts of exploitation of girl children. Child marriage is still a tradition. When in Gandhian era, that is pre-independence era, child marriage was prohibited by Sharda Act. Now we have much more well-defined acts called Child Marriage Act 2006 and also strong penal measures. Yet problem prevails not only in India but globally. We find 700 million women alive today, roughly 10% of the world's population, were married before their 18th birthday, and more than 1 in 3, that means about 250 million were unmarried before the age of 15 itself. This is UNICEF data. While there are signs of progress or reducing child marriages globally, change is not happening fast enough. And the report says up to 280 million girls alive today are at risk of becoming child brides. And unless we act, this number could rise up to 320 million by 2050. This is also from UNICEF data. And as of 2010, for example, 158 countries had a legal age of marriage of 18 years. And Global Survey 2013 shows that only 51% of countries have addressed child marriage and forced marriage during the past 5 years. Girls and young women continue to face multiple and interlocking forms of discrimination, leaving them often among the most marginalized and also vulnerable and they are hard to reach young people. Evidence demonstrates that unleashing the potential of girls and young women is an effective tool to address poverty, improve health and sanitation, and also reduce violence in communities. This is from UNDP data. And in a country which is rife with gender inequalities and an underlying nature of patriarchy, girl children often find themselves at the short end of the stick. Discrimination against girls is very rampant, and due to the fear of abuse and exploitation, they are kept at home and not being sent to school. This is the CRY data. And World Health Organization says that it is on the study of a multi-country study, which says 10 mainly developing countries in South Africa and also in Japan and Peru and other countries, it held that 15 to 71% of women experience physical and sexual violence by intimate partner of some point or other in their lives. And risk factors of this sort of violence include lower level of education and exposure to child maltreatment, and witnessing of parental violence, and also antisocial personality disorder, and also harmful use of alcohol. Since 2010, the female jail population has been the fastest growing correctional population, increasing by an average of annual rate of 3.4%. Nearly 8 in 10 female mentally ill inmates reported about their physical or sexual abuse. This is on statistics on women offenders 2016. And women were arrested of offences under the IPC during the three-year period. This was about 57,406 arrests in Andhra Pradesh and 49,333 arrests in Madhya Pradesh. And Tamil Nadu is with 49,066 and Gujarat with 41,872. And female juveniles are increasing with the reasons rooted in the poverty, behavior of others towards them at school and from cousins and relatives, along with changing lifestyles. Children joining vulnerable groups who are alcoholic and sexual exploitation, etc. And female juvenile crime rate is ranging from 15% to 29%, says Satyan Ghosh. And now we shall deal with the rights of the girl child. History might say that early man might have given primacy for the protection of women, for he observed that nature and women were the two most powerful bodies who give birth to living beings. And epics also might say that women was revered and worshipped and was allowed to intellectual discourses. But later history and present day witnessed only women exploitation, discrimination, and a non-welcoming signs of girl child and even fetal death. For they thought a girl child is a family burden and even a cause for economic loss to family in the process of her marriage. Hence, what we see today is either girls are being killed or ill-treated, not being educated and developed. And family and society together are thus perpetuating the deprived status of girl and women. A girl child can learn a lesson from looking at her mother or from her elder sister and society at large. At the same time, owing to her tender age and lack of cognizing ability due to brought up in poor conditions and brought up by illiterate parents, she may not be able to develop her status. So, girl child should know the significance of life, living in dignity. Here in this context, we need to know the significance of living in dignity and on the importance to know that each person is unique and each person certainly has a potential self to see her as a developed individual. Thus, we discuss here on a person's right to dignity and dignity in birth and brought up as a fundamental right. And for this purpose, we refer to Abraham Maslow's theory of motivation and self-actualization. Abraham Maslow is a popular psychologist. And when Maslow said what man can be, he must be, is it not an exception for women? Maslow's doctrine of self-actualization tells that human being needs are hierarchical, from physiological to safety. When safety needs are satisfied, human being aspire for fulfillment of needs for sense of belonging from family, community, and then aim at recognition of self through achievement. Ultimately, he or her looks at self pursuing his or her actual and creative interests. See the figure on Maslow's self-actualization. Hence, why not these goals are not applicable to women too? Yes, women or girl children need identity, dignity in birth and brought up. Look at the figure, Maslow's diagrammatic representation of the hierarchy of needs. Maslow often said to realize and reinforce the potential self of human beings. A musician must make music, an artist must paint, a poet must write, if he is to be ultimately at peace with himself. What a man can be, he must be, says Maslow in 1954 in his Motivation and Personality. Further, Maslow also cautioned, if a woman's needs are not recognized and she is forced to seek identity and self-esteem, only sexual fulfillment, motherhood and the possession of material things. This is referred by Friedman. For indeed, Maslow also realized that high dominant women were really psychologically free and easy and also relaxed, says Betty Friedman about Maslow. Hence, what a girl wants today is not the treatment as a superwoman of yester years or of epics or looking down attitude of today, but a healthy attitude, a human treatment. To refer Robert Ellis, who is also another psychologist in this contest, he tells, human beings are human beings, neither superhuman nor subhuman. Hence, a girl child, like any other citizen of India too, needs all the rights for its comprehensive development. And National Policy on Children 2013 provides for this dignity. It states, every child has universal, inalienable and indivisible human rights. The rights of children are interrelated and independent. Each one of them is equally important and fundamental to the well-being and dignity of the child. Childline in India is the source for this National Policy on Children 2013. All other rights we have enlisted here below are in fact, they stem from the basic right to dignity in birth and brought up. Rather, they support and sustain this fundamental right of a girl child. There are many rights and these are categorized in four categories as right to survival and health, right to development, right to protection and right to participation. Right to survival and health, right to citizenship, right to dignity in birth and right to maternity leave for mother, right to develop crèches and child care mechanisms, right to survival and health, and right to healthy and nutritious food, right to parental care of both the parents, and right to water and sanitation and standard health, and right to health care facility, and right to share in the family matters. Then comes the right to development. These are right to free expression, right to know about the development programs of the state, and right to security and defense, and right to education, right to decent standard of living for parents, and right to housing, and also right to leisure and recreation. Then comes the right to protection. Right to protection, right to equality and against discrimination, right to have good social treatment, and some other rights are right to state home shelter, right to privacy, and right to social security, and also support mechanism, and rights of female juveniles in conflict with law, and rights of juvenile pregnant, and right to reformation and also rehabilitation. These are the rights. And then comes the right to participation, and right to free expression, right to follow conscience and own religion, right to control media from obscenity, other right to participation in child matters with local and state bodies, and right for speedy justice. And these are the rights. In fact, there are various mechanisms working under this rights perspective of girl child at international level through India, and also becoming a state party to the UN Convention on the Rights of the Girl Child 1999. And India is answerable to this committee of the CRC, and also to provide and report on the rights of the child. And coming to the national level, Indian Constitution, through its fundamental rights and directive principles, insist on the provision of rights for its citizens, where child is also to be considered as a citizen. Further, it also provides certain welfare and protective legislations with a scope for amendments from time to time, and also to the changing needs of the citizens, and also considering cropping issues of citizens. All these have been already discussed in other module on constitutional protections and legislative safeguards, and also in Juvenile Justice Act relating to the child girls. But what we need today is not simply relooking at these legal provisions. Rather, our concern here is we should be on why a girl child needs a special attention regarding provisions and also protection of her rights. Hence, let us look into that direction to raise the status of the girl child. And National Policy on Children 2013 reads, every child has a right to life, survival, development, education, and also protection and participation. And every child has a right to life, survival, and development beyond the physical existence of the child, and also encompasses the right to identity and national identity. On 18th April 2013, Union Cabinet approved this national policy for children to help implementation of programs for child's development. That is why we are dealing on in this direction. Girl child's right to survival and health under this policy. As we all know that the birth of a girl child is a least welcoming event, nation brought an act to prohibit parents' choice for only boy child, and also to prevent female fetus from death through preconception and prenatal diagnostic technique, PCP and DT Act 1994. But a law cannot change age-old attitude. This needs again family education programs regarding care for girl. There are certain national policies and programs like National Health Policy 2002 and National Nutrition Mission 2002 and National Policy on Children 2013, which is a major policy that covers many aspects. This policy highlights preventing HIV infections at birth, and also it ensures infected children for medical treatment, and also adequate nutrition and accession for other rights. For this policy, insists that family or family environment should be most conducive for the all-round development of children, and children are not to be separated from their parents, except where such separation is necessary for their for the best interests of the child. Further, national program in this regard also includes Integrated Child Development Service 1975 to address malnutrition issues for children below the age of 6 years, and midday meal scheme for school children, and another program called Udisha Child Care Training Program for ICDS workers, and Sukanya Samridhi Yojana 22nd January 2015 for the schemes to ensure equitable share to a girl child in resources and savings of a family. There are some other efforts, namely through universalization of ICDS and Kishori Shakti Yojana, launching a nutrition program for adults and girls, and establishments of the Commission for Protection of Child Rights and enactment of Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act. This provides for support services of creches, daycare centers for the children of working or ailing mothers. It says, this is from Savita Bhakri source. Girl child's right to development, right to education is the major aspect for child's development. Girls are often discriminated, of this right. Many children, when they are born as a first child of the family, they are deprived of schooling. Children from farming community and other works as construction workers and as such are left behind from development. They have to look after younger siblings and to carry other household duties. Thus, even after introduction of Article 51AK that insists on parental responsibility to send children to school, girl children are not being sent to school. Thus, National Policy for Children 2013 provides for child's right to education. It gives primacy for mental, emotional, cognitive, social and cultural development of the child, and it is to be addressed in this in its totality. Further, it provides for universal and equitable access to quality early child care and education, ECCE, of all children below 6 years of age. It insists that every child in the age group 6 to 14 years is in school. It promotes affordable and accessible quality education up to secondary level for all children. It provides for foster and support intersectoral networks and linkages to provide vocational training options and enable career counseling and vocational guidance. It also ensures that all out-of-school children are tracked, rescued, rehabilitated and have an access to their right to education. Further, it addresses discrimination of all forms in schools and foster equal opportunity, treatment and participation. Further, it prioritizes education for disadvantaged groups by creating enabling environment. It ensures physical safety of the child and provides safe and secure learning environment. And this policy also ensures that all process of teaching and learning processes are child friendly, and it ensures formulation and practice of pedagogy that enables and delights children. And source is Childline in India. Apart from the National Policy on Children 2013, there are also other programs for development of the child, also girl child in particular. These are National Institute of Public Cooperation and Child Development, NIPCCD, and National Commission for Women, NCW, and National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, that is called NCPCR, and Central Adoption Resource Agency, which is also called as CERA, and Central Social Welfare Board, CSWB, and Rashtriya Mahila Kosh, RMK, of Human Resource Development. This is the source for Girl Child's Right to Protection. Indian Constitution, through its directive principles, obligates states to for protection of children rights. There are national programs like National Child Labour Protection, working since 1987 to prohibit children below the age of 14 years to work in dangerous occupations. However, National Policy for Children 2013 provides for child. Every child has the right to a dignified life free from exploitation. Safety and security of all children is integral to their well-being, and children are to be protected from all forms of harm, abuse, neglect and violence, also maltreatment and exploitation in all settings, including care institutions, schools, hospitals, creches, families and communities. The 9th plan also provided special incentives to the mother and the girl child, so that the birth of a girl child in a family is rejoiced. To this effect, in the year 1997, Balika Samriddhi Yojana BSY was launched, whereby special package consisting of ₹500 to the mother and annual scholarship ranging from ₹300 to 1000 for education of girl children from class 1 to 10th was provided to all those family living below the poverty line to ensure that all girl children went to schools. The incentive of ₹500 to the mother on the delivery of a girl child was limited to two girl children only. Similar initiatives were also launched by other state governments. In 1998, the government, with the support of UNICEF, launched a special service for children called Childline. This is a free phone service that can be accessed by child or anyone on his or her behalf simply by dialing the number 1098. At present, Childline is working in 68 cities through a network of NGOs which not only respond to the needs of children but also play a major role in crisis interventions, long-term care and rehabilitation. Realizing the need for an effective service delivery to children in need of care and protection, a national initiative for child protection was launched through the National Institute of Social Defense and Childline India Foundation. Further, we shall deal with the girl child's right to participation. Girl child is hardly allowed to speak even today. She is generally brought up with oversensitive care for being girl, not allowed to speak aloud. She is not allowed to be in association with friends and others very easily. But a child has to share many of her views and problems with others. Otherwise, she is prone to suffer at highest cost. National Policy on Children 2013 reiterates the rights conferred in the Universal Convention on the Rights of the Girl Child and the Rights of the Child 1989 in this respect. All children have equal rights and no child shall be discriminated on grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, place of birth, class, language and disability, social or economic or any other status. And further, the best interests of the child is a primary concern in all decisions and actions affecting the child, whether taken by legislative bodies, courts of law, administrative authorities, public, private, social, religious or cultural institutions. Children are capable of forming views in any way. They are able to communicate in matters affecting them. Further, children's views are to be heard in all matters affecting them, in particular judicial and administrative proceedings and interaction, and their views given due consideration and administrative proceedings and interactions, and their voice given should be given due consideration in accordance with their age, maturity and also evolving capacities. Now we shall deal with some suggestions. We may consider the following suggestions and also some initiatives to improve the status of girl child. Agarwal in 2000 says that education is a process which draws out its best in the child with the aim of producing well-balanced personalities, culturally refined, emotionally stable, ethically sound, mentally alert, morally upright, physically strong, socially efficient, spiritually upright, vocationally self-sufficient and internationally liberal. Hence, a girl child has to aim at getting educated. Remembering the popular people who strive to serve the nation in the past, a girl child should aim high by not giving mere attention to the fashion model icons. As we learn from Maslow's theory of self-identification, dignity of child lies in with what and with whom she identifies. Her identification of her potential self is the first step for her growth. Santa Sinha recalls incidents on female feed side and also said in her public speech, Dharmapuri, Salem and Madurai have shocked the nation on this account. The news of a doctor who has admitted to illegally aborting 260 female fetuses after the police finding dozens of tiny bones in the basement of his maternity clinic in Gurgaon. Santa Sinha continues to say that programs and policies for infants and young children are woefully weak, lacking in seriousness about protecting their rights. The tragedies of infants being abandoned by poor parents is an indication of a collapse of all the institutions that are designed to take care of children, especially girls. The need of the hour is for the government to make wholehearted investment on children and guarantee their rights. At the same time, it is essential to build a social norm in favor of their rights and empower local institutions and processes to bring pressure on the government to deliver service efficiently, just so that children live a life long and life enjoying their special privilege, which is their childhood. In this regard, one must look at the significant work done by the agencies such as the Indian Red Cross in Punjab. Further, it is necessary to have a strong voice in the civil society from the religious groups. The SJPC statement that the Sikh code of conduct does not approve of girls being seen as unequal under and their dignity has to be protected as a moral and spiritual act, and it must make a difference. And it is time that all other religious groups join hands in this campaign and the political parties to come up with a code of conduct for all citizens, says Santa Sinha. Then Savita Bakri, she stressed on the need to improving water and sanitation coverage both in rural and urban areas. Sanitation measure is an important aspect, especially for the rights of the girl child in rural areas. Often she is put to shame and exploitation for lack of water and proper sanitation facility. Further, Savita Bakri suggests to address girl children who have been victims of sexual abuse. Response to their needs has been ad hoc and largely in the form of relief. Further, she advises on the need to bring about improvement in the standards of service in most state-run institutions and those run by voluntary organizations. Further, Millennium Development Goals, especially Goal 2, is about extending educational opportunity for all children with particular emphasis on girls, says the Save the Children 2008. Further, Girls Not Brides is a global partnership of more than 800 civil society organizations committed ending child marriage and enabling girls to fulfill their potential. This is also from Save the Children. Now, we shall deal with the summary. We have discussed on the rights of the girl child, which are deprived due to family tradition and also due to socio-economic statuses, which are poor. At the same time, we have not actually discussed the mere legal provisions embedded in the Constitution of India or other legislations. Rather, we were discussing on various other measures to make aware the parents and girl children and about the national policies and programs for children. Further, there are many child helplines and non-governmental organizations that are ready to take action against violation of child rights and also for providing counseling and rehabilitation of the children affected. Though we have not enlisted all the programs and services for girl children, this module might have given many insights in the area of the rights of the girl child. Thank you.